67 तो हो गए, 47 मेरे ख्याल से। हाँ
यस सर, वी आर स्टार्टिंग नाउ सर। ठीक है, सो वेरी गुड इवनिंग टू ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स एंड अवर रिस्पेक्टेड रिसोर्स पर्सन। आई एम साजिद शेख, आई एम द कोऑर्डिनेटर ऑफ द सेंटर फॉर रिसर्च इन इंटेलेक्चुअल प्रॉपर्टी, एंड आई एम वेरी ऑनर्ड टूडे बिकॉज वी हैव विद अस डॉक्टर डब्ल्यू एम धुमाने, हु इज द DPIIT IPR chair at Maharashtra National Law University, Mumbai. And formerly, he has been a senior joint controller of patents and designs with the Intellectual Property Office. And in the Intellectual Property Office itself, he has worked in various capacities. He has been a leader in, you know, a lot of policy related initiatives. And MNLU Mumbai is very honored to have Dr. Dhumane as the IPR chair professor. Today's topic is very unique because, and you know, it is a bit technical also in nature because it deals with filing and processing of patents. And there is no better expert than Dr. Dhumane because he has worked in this very area at the IP office. So I won't take much time. And I'll now request and invite Dr. Dhumane to kindly give his talk on patent filing and processing. Over to you, sir. Most welcome.
Thank you, Professor Sajid. Thank you for your good introduction. And good afternoon to all participants here. Today's topic is, as Professor Sajid has said, is a patent filing and processing. And there are many intricacies involved in that. And when you want to file your applications, think of rather filing applications, and you are most of the people do not know as how to proceed. So today I will extend my knowledge to you in this regard. And you are free to ask any doubts and ask any questions on this as per this Zoom will allow you like that. And now we are starting. So this is the first slide. We generally, because we have to start some basics initially, that we know that intellectual property rights comprises patent, designs, trademark, copyright, geographic indication, semiconductor, IC layout, and plant variety. Out of these, patent, design, trademark, copyright, GI, semiconductor are with Department of Promotion of Industry and Technology Transfer, like that. And plant variety is being looked after by Ministry of Agriculture. These IPR areas, although they are controlled by separate acts of the Parliament, and each IPR is having unique identity, unique scope also. So for example, the patent, when we call the patents, it is given for inventions and it is a technical solution to a technical problem. So when there is some technical problem to be resolved, then that solution, if you find out, that may be worth patenting. Designs has nothing to do with this technical matters. It is simply a register for the external features, which can be new shape, pattern on configuration, and such new shape must appeal to an eye and only judge by eye, nothing. What is inside, we are not bothered about that. Trademark is again, is different from this, and it involves only distinct to symbol, maybe word, name, logo, label, etc., which is applied to the article like Bata, Tata, etc. These are trademark which you are very familiar. Copyright again, is very different from all three. This is artistic creation in the form of novel, drama, picture, sound recording, etc. For any artistic creation, and as soon as you create that, copyright is registered. It is established. When it is registered, it is legally valid. And then you do not prove it. It is similar to trademark, which doesn't require registration, but if you register, you can establish your ownership on this. GI is again different from all this. It's a public property is cannot be owned by individual. So association of persons can own it for agricultural, natural, manufactured goods from a definite territory, which are identified by special quality or reputation, like basmati, Nagpur oranges, and other things, like Kanjivaram silk sarees, Darjeeling tea, etc. Semiconductor IC layout design is not much in hope, but it is given to the layout of transistor and other circuitry elements in a semiconductor integrated circuits. And last is planned variety. It is not IPI per se, it is sui generis system given for the protection of farmers' and breeders' right for creating or developing the new and extant plant varieties. So you can see that all these IPRs are different from each other. There is no overlapping, and they have individual scope of their own. But maximum of this IPR can be applied on a single article. Let us take the example of watch. Here, patent can be given for the technology which is used in the watch. Design for external features, how it looks, shape, etc., where trademark is for the name and copyright is for the information brochure along with that watch. GI here can be for the Swiss made watches or location wise watches that can be GI. Now this all these intellectual property have many common things, and these common things are these all are IPRs, IP are creations of human mind. So when there are ideas in the human mind and they take the shape or form of some manifestation, some product, some articles, then they become IPR. So basically they are creations of human mind. They do not protect ideas, but although they come from the ideas, they do not protect the ideas, but they are given for the manifestation of ideas, and they are given as an exclusive statutory right for a limited period of time. These IPRs created through ideas and manifested in the form of products and process become tradable commodities, can be sold, can be assigned, can be licensed also, and you can earn benefit of money out of that by way of licensing. And these IP assets are sometimes more important than physical assets, because all these modern companies are worldwide, they use intellectual property rights because they give exclusive right to prevent others from using that without permission, and they establish certain superiority in the market. You are unique in that if you have got patent or trademark of that. Therefore, these are more important than physical assets for many leading companies. And in 1997, out of top 100 MNCs, 80% used tangible assets, and only 20% intangible assets. The picture is just upside down in 2019, where these 100 top MNCs use only 20% tangible assets and 80% intangible assets, that is IPRs. So the most leading companies are in the modern age are dependent on these IPRs. Having introduced IPR, then let us turn now on our topic, that is patent. So as we have said, patents are given for invention. And invention, the meaning which we read is slightly different in terms of patent language. So for the purpose of Patent Act, invention means a new product or process involving an inventive step and capable of being industrially applicable. So there are three criteria for any product or process to be patentable. That is, it should be new, that is novel, the novelty should be there. It should have inventive step, that is one step more. If you are in you see what it is. Novelty is does not form part of state of the art. So for such a product or process to be new, there should not be prior knowledge, prior publication of this in the literature or in any public domain. Inventive step, the second criteria for patentability, that is, it should contain a feature, that is an invention that involves technical advance as compared to the existing knowledge, or economic significance, or both. Means your invention should give some technical advancement over the prior art, over the substance already existing. So that product should contain technical advancement and as compared to the prior art, and then it should have economic significance, maybe this or both. And next criteria is such invention should not be obvious or a person skilled in the art. Who is the person skilled in the art? Person skilled in the art is not, although not defined in the act, but is a presumed to be an ordinary practitioner. Person skilled in the art is around us, and if invention goes to him, although he is not expert, but he can use that invention by virtue of his knowledge, which he is already having by ordinary experience. So your invention should not be obvious to a person skilled in the art or being eligible for grant of patent. So there are three criteria, and our product or process, if this criteria are fulfilled, may become eligible for patent. So it is essential to know for what patent is granted, and if you think for applying for any patent, so you should know the basic things about what the patent is and for what it is given. Now, what we have said is the patent is IPR, intellectual property right, which is just like any other properties, can be assigned, can be sold, can be transferred, and for value consideration, and there is technology transfer, etc. Where technology is given to other firm, then there is a consideration, money involved, like this. So this patent confers certain rights on the patentee. That is, patent is statutory right granted for an invention to the inventor or his assignee. Means if you are invented, then you are inventor. You can enjoy your right, or if you are not in a position to enjoy the right, you can transfer this invention to other person. That is called assignee. So you are assigning your invention to the third party. So that third party becomes owner of patent, and patent can be granted to him also. It is given for limited period of 20 years from the date of filing. Then it is exclusive right. What does it mean? It excludes others. This invention for which patent has been given can be used by the patentee by excluding others from making, using, offering for sale, selling, or importing any product covered by a patent, or from using the process or a product obtained by that process if a patent is for process. Right, so this patent right can be shared, licensed, or sold. This patent right can initiate legal proceeding for an infringement action. This patent right is open for free use. So patent given for any invention can be freely used once the term is over. That is, after 20 years, anybody can use the patent. Invention can be commercially exploited without fear of copying when you have patent. And this patent right is not absolute right. It is given under certain conditions. That is, it can be used by the government, acquired by the government. In case of emergency, government can give license to others also. So the public interest provisions are there to dilute this monopoly to certain extent. Sajid, is it clear now, audible now?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So this patent rights, nature of patent rights is very important to understand. So you are getting the patent right only for limited term, that 20 years. Thereafter, anybody can use. There is no bar on that. But this patent right within 20 years also, term or within the term of patent also, these certain limitations are imposed for to avoid the inconvenience of the public, so that this patented invention is available to the needy persons. For that purpose, government can step into, can acquire the patent, can license the patent to other persons so that sufficient production is there for the patented product, or can acquire the patent also. So it has certain limitations. So why should one get a patent? His invention is there, There is another way for him to publish his application, publish his invention in the journals and get a credit that he's, he has published papers. But this published paper, you do not have any right over that, and it can be whatever new things you have published can be utilized by others, and you cannot stop them. So you do not get any benefit out of that, nor get any monopoly. It is a is common public domain. But patent right, once given to you, you are you become exclusive owner. You can stop others unless they are given permission from you. So this patent, another uses for this benefits of patent right is that it avoids duplication of research. Because the patent, as we have seen, patent rights are given for new and novel things. It means only those things invented afresh, new, is eligible for patent. So it is a virgin knowledge coming to you. So there is no prior art on that. And anybody who wants to do further research can take one step ahead, can jump ahead on this invention. So you need not reinvent the wheel because wheel is already there. But if you want to work more, you can use this invention and go ahead with that, with your research work. So the published, these all patent applications, patent grant, patents granted, etc., they are not secret. They are published in journal regularly, and it is must compulsory, mandatory by law. So all patent applications filed and patent granted are published in patent journal, so that anybody can view it. Anybody can copy, get a copy of that. But certainly you cannot copy the invention, but you can plan your research. You can license in that patent if you are you are manufacturing in that area, so that the patent published patent applications is available at the click of a mouse. You can have any knowledge of the patented literature. So it is a valuable source of technology information, which is useful for planning your R&D and for forging alliances and identifying possible collaborators. So if you are not able, patent is not able to commercialize the invention, he can find collaborators and start manufacturing of the invented products or process. This because of the because patents are given for new products or new processes, industry can improve the existing technology to give cheaper and better products. If we take a case of mobile technology, you can say sea of change from the initial mobiles, now very high performing and technically advanced system of mobiles, because industry is constantly using this patented invention to produce newer and cheaper products. So if you have patented some technology, new technology, then you are preeminent player in the market. So others have to take license from you. And so patent is tool for international trade, because if the foreign firm, they are getting patent in India, which is possible as per the law, then this if somebody, some vendor or entrepreneurs in India want to trade on that, want to manufacture that, they have to take license from international firm. So international trade is facilitated. So India's patent regime prevents evergreening. This is a special feature of the Patent Act. As I said, Patent Act is passed by the Parliament, and our Patent Act, Indian Patent Act, contains provisions that no patent can be misused. It includes the provisions for stopping evergreening of the patents. So with this background, that what is patent, for what is given, and you are prepared to file application, then what are the prerequisites? If you think of filing patent application, what you should have? You should have an invention which reasonably fulfills the criteria of novelty, inventive step, and industry applicability, which you are just now seen. Means why reasonably? Because to assess this criteria is the job of patent office. While making application, you may not be fully aware that this invention has 100% fulfilling novelty or inventive step, but reasonable idea should be there so that the patent application does not get outrightly rejected by the patent office. Because for getting patents, you have to file application in the patent office in your jurisdiction, and patent office will examine the application, and if patent office finds that it fulfills the criteria of patentability and further it does not involve any of the category of non-patented invention, because there are certain inventions for which patents are not granted. There are various reasons. They are anti-public or something, some prohibited by law, etc. So there are certain inventions in Section 3 that patents are not granted. So patentability, that is criteria of novelty, inventive step, and industrial applicability, plus any of the category for which patent can be granted, you should have a fair idea about invention, that your invention fulfills these conditions. Then you have invention, but you should be very sure about that you have right to file application. You are owner of invention. Sometimes you are working with another workers in the R&D laboratory. Then that fellow also has a right. So you have to identify as a right. And you can jointly apply. There is no bar. There can be any number of applicants or single application. They can jointly apply. So you should identify who are the co-owners of the right. And if you are, say, for example, company, and invention is coming from your employer, then who is authorized to file application? Basically, inventor, who has invented the patented patentable product or process. But there is agreement between company and the employee. So employee cannot file patent application. So company must get this agreement signed, or some assignment done in favor of company, or transfer of ownership of the patent invention, so that company becomes authorized to file patent. So in short, you should have right to apply. That is assignment deed, etc. Patent office will ask for that, right? I told you there are co-applicants. In application, you should add all the names who have claimed on the patentable invention. So that later on, there should not be any complaint by anybody who is left out, although he is inventor. So there are long procedures to avoid that. Better to add all inventors' name. And one more thing, patent is given in India for the applicant for patent and not for inventors merely. Of course, inventor can become applicant if he is applicant, but he is not applicant, his company or other university or any entity is applicant. The inventor has no right on the gains which are likely from the patent. So there can be arrangement between the assignee, that is, say, for example, university or professor or company or inventor, that certain benefits will be passed on to inventor, but suo moto, the inventors, although their names appear in patent application, they do not exercise any rights or powers over the patent which will be granted in due course of time. So this thing must be known. So if you are inventor, then while making agreement with your employer or company or any third party, so be sure that your rights are sure. Be sure that you are getting something out of your invention. It is not just being snatched away from you. There are many cases happen like this. So you should identify your right vis-a-vis the benefit out of that. If you are applicant, for example, if you are individual, individual can be applicant, or any entity can be applicant. If you are able to file on your own, you can, because patent filing is still a slightly tedious process in the sense that patent applications have to be prepared in the proper format. You have to claim the property in the invention. That is, what is exactly the right you want to claim, etc. So it should be prepared in the proper format. If you are able to prepare your own, then okay, no doubt. But if you are not, then employ the patent agent, right? Say, and further thing, if you are, say, your place of business or jurisdiction, we will see, but you are in proper jurisdiction. There are four jurisdictions, that is Mumbai, Delhi, Calcutta, and Madras, which covers the geographical parts of India, different parts. So you should fulfill the condition of jurisdiction for filing of patent. If you file in wrong jurisdiction, that application is not considered. So from the discussion so far, that is criteria for patentability, it follows that we are not supposed to do certain things. That is, you should not publish prior to filing because that will kill novelty. You should not publish any article or press release, conference presentation, poster, proceedings, or blog before filing a patent application. It will lose novelty and your application is not valid. You should not give any lecture or presentation prior to filing, except under, say, if there is a company and they want to commercialize, so you are bound to give presentation. So there should be non-disclosure agreement, NDA, for this. Otherwise, your right to patent will be lost. You seek professional advice as early as possible when you finalize the patented invention. And you are ready to file it, to seek the professional advice, and must file before others do, because there are many people simultaneously working on the same idea, same project, and they may arrive at the same result as you. So no two patents can be given for the same purpose. This is given purely based on the date of filing. If he files earlier to you, then your right is lost. These are certain things to remember, because you must remember that 25% of all R&D efforts are wasted each year on inventions that have already been invented. Means they cannot file because of all these mistakes. And don't start your R&D until you have done research. Second advice is that you, before thinking of filing, you be sure that your research is correct, to the point, and eligible for filing of patent application. So these are certain things you must remember before filing application. Now, a little bit about the novelty, because when you file application, you must know where you stand as far as novelty is concerned. The novelty for the patent application in India comprises three parts. So your application, your invention rather, should not be published prior to your date of filing anywhere in the world, in any format, in patent literature or non-patent literature. This is first thing. Second thing, nobody should have filed patent applications on the same invention prior to your date. That's what I was mentioning. Although, because publication of, I told you that all patent applications are published, but they may be published later on. Suppose you have filed today and you are not aware that somebody else has already filed, and that application is published later on before your date, then you cannot get patent for that. Although two applications filed on the same date may get patent for both, but not earlier to that date. Third is that there should not be any prior use of an invention in India. So prior claiming and prior public use relate to Indian situation, whereas publication relates to
We are trying to get in touch with Dr. Dumane. Please wait. Hello, sir. Can you hear me? Sir, your mic is on mute.
Is now okay?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir. Correct now? You can see now?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
This is novelty means state comparison between your invention and similar invention in the paragraph. And there should be difference, identifiable difference between the two. And where this such difference exists, your invention is novel. So there are certain things which are not novelty killing, although they are published, they are happening before your filing date. Sajid, is it clear na? Dr. Sajid, can you hear me?
Hello, sir. Yes, sir.
Can you hear me na?
Okay. Yes, sir. Yes.
Now, under the Patent Act, there are certain things which are not killing novelty. That the application published before 1/1/2012 are of no relevance. If your invention is obtained by a third party without your consent and publisher already filed, etc., that is not valid application. You are still owner of the application. So it is not killing novelty if obtained from you. This happens in a company or universities, etc., where the due credit is not given to research student and is obtained from him, there are remedies for that. Or even if you communicate to government for government purpose, not file application, but these are no killing factors for the novelty. Another facility is given for the research community is that if you display your invention or exhibit in the exhibition, and are used with the consent of inventor. You are inventor. You are given consent for using for some purpose at industrial exhibition, notified government, and published in the proceedings of that meeting. Or a research paper is presented on the invention, or it is used for reasonable trial, which is necessary for working of patent. And having done this, that is, display public use or receive a publication, you must file patent application within 1 year of such event. Then there is still novelty, and novelty cannot be in question. So this is special consideration given for maintaining novelty. For novelty purpose, only single document cited prior art means whatever it is there in public domain. There is straightway comparison between that one comparison. The patent office cannot say that I have five citations, and by virtue of these five, when I compare invention, now it is not there. This cannot be said. Only one document is to be compared with your invention to say that there is no novelty. So mosaicing is not allowed. Then, even if patent office finds that there is some document like that document should be of relevance to your invention, that by virtue of document that invention should be carried out. So if that is limitations are there, then that document cannot kill your novelty. And and if you have given that invention to such a third party, further to your friend or your company, to enterprise, under seal of agreement, seal of confidence, that they will not use it, they will not publish it, then your right is still there, and they cannot say that it is in public domain. The basic important is that your invention should not be in public domain before date of filing. So these are the exceptions for that. So patent office compares your invention application with the database they are having. They find out certain document and then raise the objection that the invention is novel otherwise. And here, if there is single person claims that I was knowing your invention before your date of filing, then novelty may be killed, may be challenged also. For example, in one case where there's two book are developed by certain inventor, he brought in the house, and then his male servant took their two cycle with the kid in the park, which was seen by many, and later patent applicants filed, there was a position that this two cycle was seen by many like this. So novelty killing, you should be very careful not to display or disclose your invention prior to filing your application. Even one person who is reliably witness can says that I have seen it, this invention may kill your novelty. And important thing is that if inventor, if prior inventor, I mean to say, if keeps his invention secret, does not make it public, and you have filed application, such keeping the invention secret by prior holder is not killing your novelty. So that prior knowledge, prior publication, prior art should be visible to public, available to public, freely accessible also. Then only it becomes prior art, then only your invention is liable to be said as it not being novel, unless not. In patent office, your application examined by examiner, and he is much more qualified than you or anybody. He cannot say that I know this in art or technology beforehand, because his own knowledge is not going to kill novelty of invention. So this is for novelty. Inventive second criteria, what we say, is to be invention should not be obvious. When there is a combination of two, say in chemicals, then you mix them, obviously it can be admixture. So if there will be some synergistic effect, if the effect is mixing together and getting new product in no synergistic effect, then that is inventive. But this invention should not come because there is a big motor available and you are making small mini size motor with almost similar technology. It is only size difference. It is just like does not involve the inventive step. It may be treated as mechanical equivalent unless new technologies made to make such motors. So anything which is just mechanical equivalent or which comes readily to a person's skill art, that I can also make this, so that we, that may establish that there is no inventive step in your applications. So for inventive step, the whole prior art is considered, and examiner in patent office will cite more than one document to show that your invention is non-inventive, and for which you have to provide right reply, your agent, that by virtue of this comparison, you have made a wrong comparison, it is not applicable, like blah, 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 blah. You have to establish that my invention is still inventive, my invention is still novel, and the prior art cited by you is not valid, not applicable. Industrial applicable, similarly, you should, of course, the nature of the invention itself demonstrates the industrial application, because in the application, you have to give certain use of the invention, working of invention, that indicates the industry applicability. But if it is not given, you have to separately mention industry applicability of the, and certain inventions cannot be industrial applicable. For example, method of treatment, invention applied for personal use, method of smoking, style, etc., method of making makeup, all these are for personal use and they cannot be commercialized. Industry applicable, applicability is not fulfilled. And then invention that can be applied only for academic purpose, etc., these are not industry produce, so industrial applicability condition is not fulfilled. Certain things are not patentable. As I said, we have seen, you have to be very sure that these inventions are patentable. Now there are inventions which may be patentable otherwise, but Act says by virtue of different reason they are not patentable, which is frivolous or is contrary to well established laws. That is, machine giving 100%, more than 100% performance, it is not reality. So this invention is not patentable. I am going to briefly give you details of inventions which are not patentable under section 3. That is this one. Second is, the use of the invention is contrary to public order or morality, and patent cannot be granted there. For example, device for housebreaking, if somebody claims patent for that, it is not patentable. Mere discovery of scientific principle or formulation or abstract theory, or discovery of any living thing, or discovery of non-living substance is not patentable. So discoveries as such are not patentable, only inventions. So invention has the contribution from individual, whereas discovery comes to you as it is. For example, Archimedes principle, superconducting phenomena, these are the things for which patent can be granted. Mere discovery, new form, in case of drugs, pharmaceutical, mere discovery or mere use of known form, etc., they are not patentable under section 3D. And only if there is certain efficacy, means technical advancement, or the application of that new use or new form of substance, then it may be patentable. Otherwise, new form of known substance is not patentable. Similarly, if mixing two components just involves admixture only, such mixture is not patentable unless there is value addition to that. So A plus B should be more than C, which is called synergistic effect of value addition. Otherwise, it is not patentable. Then rearrangement of, if you arrange a clock and radio in single cabinet and give effect of new invention, that is not patentable. Both should be invention on their own. Then method of agriculture, horticulture are not patentable to take care of the farmer's interest. So method of treatment, that is medicinal, surgical, curative, or diagnostic treatment, therapeutic treatment are not patentable because these are used by the doctors by virtue of their knowledge to save the life of a patient. And moreover, this cannot be industrialized. These are specific to doctors. So the third condition, that method of treatment is not patentable because it is not industry applicable. Then plants and animals and any whole or any part is not patentable in India. Mathematical methods of computer program per se, softwares are not patentable. Then other thing, the products which are copyrightable, literary, dramatic, musical, artistic work, there is no patent for that. And then lastly, traditional knowledge as such is not patentable unless you create some formulation by virtue of mixing traditional known component into new and useful product, then it may be patentable, but otherwise not. So these are the inventions which are not patentable. So while framing mindset for finding application, you have to think of whether my invention is contained in any one of the criteria here mentioned, or it is fulfilling novelty, industrial application, and inventive state. Once that is done, this is now we come filing of patent applications. There are various types of patent applications. That is ordinary application, which Indians are filing in India, domestic applications, and there are invented and filed. There is no priority, means there is no history of other applications abroad. This is ordinary application. Convention applications, when Paris Convention makes many countries, more than 170 countries are members of Paris Convention. So any application filed by the citizen of that country gets equal rights and equal treatment by other member. So the Paris Convention is useful for if somebody makes application in parent country, then wants to make application in India, he can do so within 12 months of original filing without losing novelty. Second is patent of addition. Even if you file something, some application for certain products or process, and you think that this small improvements I have made further to that, I can I cannot file separate application, but simply it is new. So you can add that new part, new improvement to the existing application. This is called patent of addition. Next, division application means you are not supposed to file application which does not have single inventive concept, because Patent Act provides patent, one patent for one invention. And group of inventions based on single inventive concept are eligible for single patent, but if it is not so, then you have to divide the applications. PCT national phase application, it is in response to PCT patent cooperation treaty when citizens of other countries can file in India the patent applications within 31 months of the filing of that application in parent country. And PCT international phase application, when Indians file abroad under PCT, that is called PCT international phase application. As I said, you should bother about jurisdiction of patent, because you have to file your application in the proper jurisdiction. What is that? Application is to be filed as per territorial remits, because the patent rises territorial to India. It is not valid in other countries unless you file application abroad. So even territorial right, say person from Chennai can file in Chennai patent office or South Zone. So there are demarcated different areas of the country to different offices. For example, in Maharashtra, in Mumbai, Gujarat, then Chhattisgarh, MP, and Goa. They come under the jurisdiction. So any person from these states can file in Mumbai office or having normal residence or as a domicile or place of business in this area. And he has to provide the address for service of this area. Now, foreign applicants who do not have business in India, they can file application, convention application or PCT application. So there is no question of proper place, but they have to provide address for service in India, that is address or agent to whom they are filed. So divisional file application must be filed to place of original jurisdiction. These are the appropriate office. So while filing parent application, you should bother about this. Applicant, if you are true and first inventor, or you are assignee of inventor, or you are company or legal entity, you are representative of the person who is deceased, you are eligible for filing patent applications. Filing of patent application can be made in two stages. Either you can file provisional application or you can file complete specific application to complete specification immediately. When provisional application is filed, when your work is not ready completely, you mention it, and it is likely to require more time. But substantial part is done, and you are afraid that somebody may take this invention. So file an application with provisional specification, which does not require any more details to secure the priority date, means a date of filing application, which is unique to the application. And nobody can claim that I have filed earlier. So you are the first person to reveal that knowledge to patent office by filing provisional application.
Sir, may I interject? You have like 10 minutes, sir.
Yeah, I will finish. Yeah. Okay. Now, these provisional applications, when there is urgency of filing, the inventors are leaving the company. So, after filing provisional, you can file a complete specification having details that within 12 months from that date. So, earlier date will be prevailed. If you have paid the fees earlier, it will also be valid. And this complete specification may contain all details, which are this complete claim also, that what property you want to claim. So if you are startup, then there are special conditions of filing under patent acts, and there is 80% concession in patent filing fees, all fees for startups. And then you can file through the facilitator under SIPB scheme, special scheme launch, where all your fees for agent will be reimbursed by the government. So application must, you require to file form 1, then form 2, preamble, whether pertinent or complete, then separately drawing an abstract, and you have to take permission from the certificate for DIPP if you are startup. You have to establish the assignment for proof of right and a power of attorney, etc., required to file along with the applications. For patent, if you are filing to patent agent, e-filing is compulsory, the online filing. You cannot file physical format. Physical format is our hard copy filing is available if you are filing, if you are not filing to patent agent. This is something preamble. This form 2 means this first phase, and all subsequent pages will contain disclosure of the invention and claims, etc. You are making declaration that the following specification particularly describes the nature of invention. This is for and the manner in which it is to be performed. You have to give this declaration. You can file. You have to take license of foreign filing. You have to, if your invention pertains to any defense purpose, then it will refer to defense and it will not be published. Or if your invention relates to biological resources, then you have to take permission from National Biodiversity Authority. This is the general procedure for procedure for filing as well as processing of applications. For example, as we have said, your application is filed, then it is published. Published after 18 months, the normal practice, you can ask them to publish early by filing Form 9 and filing fees. After this publication, then and you have to file request for examination also. Unless request for examination is filed, it is not examined. Unless it is published, it is not examined. So publication of application and request for examination is compulsory for getting the application published. After publication, third party can launch opposition also. So all this then will be passed on to the examiner or examination. And he conducts examination for all novelty, inventivity, as we have said, in documents, database. Then he will file the report to the, his superior, that controller, who will go through that and frame his opinion, whether patent can be granted, whether it exists novelty, inventive, etc. If not, if there are objections, he will give hearing to the applicant, who comes for hearing, explain to the controller that this we can amend the application. If he cannot explain, he cannot meet the objection. So either by amendment or by a satisfying explanation, controller accepts that patent can be granted, and he will grant the patent. The grant of patent is published immediately in the journal, whereupon post-grant opposition can be filed. So after publication of original first publication, then this, anybody can use the invention, anybody can get license from you, and is available on the website. These are general grounds which are available in the FAQ, because in the patent office website, there is a FAQ which deals with all these stages of filing, etc., and you can gain knowledge for that. And if patent cannot be granted, then hearing is must, and this decision is given in the quasi judicial way. Controls are considered as quasi judicial authority for grant of patent. So his decision can be opposed also. So the award is patent. If they are not granted, then he can file the petition under higher forum, that is IPEB also. The special case of expiry examination made available for startups or ISA applicant, those who are filing PCT application abroad, or who are women, SMEs, government department, or other categories, special categories, they can file their application for patent to get examination expedited. They can get patent within 1 year from the filing of request or expedited examination, which otherwise takes few years. So these are the special concern given to these categories. So grant of patent is published, and there and when there is no objection and there is no contravention of any law and all objections have been made and pre-grant opposition is also settled, then patent is granted. In case of refusal, I told you, then hearing is given. And once patent is granted, then you have, for maintaining the patent, you have to pay the renewal fees annually. So this is in brief, about the filing of applications and filing of and proceeding application by patent office and care to be taken by the applicants before filing, after filing, and preparing proper reply in case there are objections by the patent office to get the patent and reap the benefits of granted patent for himself or through licensing or consideration, because patent is techno-commercial legal instrument or reaping the benefits from the patent innovations. So, Sajid, I end here. Thank you all participants. Any questions coming? Sajid?
Yes, sir.
Any questions? I have finished my presentation. I hope I am within time, although there was little bit hurry, but okay, that I have made my point clear. So, any questions coming? Otherwise, we'll switch off.
Okay, participants, if you have any queries, we can spend around 2 to 3 minutes on those questions.
If no query, then we can stop, isn't it?
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Just a second. One question is there. How are two patents claimed on the same day dealt with?
Same day means
two patents are same invention.
Yeah, because the difference of one day is considered valid. Means previous day, but same day means both will get patent.
All right.
He filed both, but same applicant filing two applications will be clubbed together. Only one patent will be granted to him for one invention.
So next question is there a specified application form for filing the patent?
Yes, form one is compulsory to be filled in, allowing declaration that you are taken biological resources or you have sufficient proof of right, the inventor's name, inventor have to sign the patent application, their form one, right? And if form one is an application form, and then the patent specification disclosure is made in form two, as I showed you. And both are to be filed with fees.
Right, sir. One last question is, what if, like these days, inventions are being made by help of artificial intelligence?
Yes.
So
although there are not specific rules for that, but there is a exception to patentability in section 3K that computer programs are not patentable, right? So within that, meaning if the conditions of patentability is fulfilled, novelty, inventive, because it is necessary to fulfill the criteria of patentability, 3 criteria, and it should not be included in any non-patent innovation. That is the thing which is seen by patent examiner and nothing else. So you have to prepare the application, maybe IoT or artificial intelligence in such a way that they are fulfilling this criteria. I have seen many patents being granted for IoT also, Internet of Things, my patent office here.
Right.
Similar thing maybe for AI also.
Of course, for AI, but
ownership patent, issues are there.
Ownership issues
are there. But recently there was judgment that US court has refused to accept the machine as the owner of the invention.
Right.
US jurisdiction recently, couple of months. So the man behind
in corporate, there was this very case of selfie.
Patent case was there here, which was refused. So man behind the machine is still important.
Right. One question is, invention can be commercially exploited during the term of patent.
Yes.
That, however, seems to defeat the purpose of patent. please elaborate.
No, because once application visa file is published in the journal, then it is open. If there is, and before grant and after publication, this can be commercialized by the patent application owner, right? There is no bar. As if patent is granted to him. As if patent is granted to him after publication, it can be commercialized, it can be licensed too also, there is no bar. It does not defeat the patent purpose of patent application.
The whole purpose behind the patent regime or the IP regime is to grant a limited kind of monopoly. And yes. not an unlimited monopoly. So
it is not limited, it is the unlimited only. Because later on,
unlimited for a certain period of time.
Yes.
So that is why we say that there is a limited monopoly only for a period of 20 years.
20 years.
That's, in the that's case of patents, not 20, unlimited. For lifelong, you cannot.
You know, 20 claim years the monopoly. Or till you pay the renewal fees. Or your patent is seized by because invalid also. So after any seizure, invalidity, or expiry of term, anybody can expire that patent without any bar. After patent life is over, that's why people are waiting for pharmaceutical product patent to end the term. As soon as term is ended, the generic manufacturers are ready to manufacture those medicines. You are aware of that.
Yes, sir. Sir, one more question if you are willing to take, sir.
Yeah, sure.
Is there any qualification to be a patent applicant?
No, not okay. At all. Not at all.
But patent agents are required.
Yes. So, they are science graduate or engineering graduate or medical graduate.
Can an individual himself file a patent, yes, or they require a patent agent?
No. Engaging patent agent is not compulsory at all. Even the company, enterprise can file application on their own by drafting, etc. And they may not engage the patent agent also. It is allowed. Individual is also allowed. So engaging patent agent is not compulsory.
But sir, many companies and mostly everyone, they engage a patent agent.
Yeah, because drafting is specific art. It requires a claim to be drafted. Claim means your invention, what are the rights you want? What is that component? For example, you claim product. So specifically that will be mentioned. And there is a difference between the published paper and invention, a disclose specification, because in published publication you disclose very certain narrow things only. In patent application you are allowed to claim certain broader things which are coming around, and those you have to cover those broader things in claims. That requires skill and knowledge, and patent agents are skilled in that to make suitable claim, not to do anything, because the basic principle is in patent, if you do not claim anything, that can disclaim and becomes property of others also. So your invention is valuable. Don't do anything disclaim. So include everything in the patent claim while making applications. Therefore, services of patent agent may be required, may be preferred, particularly by big companies. Individuals cannot afford their fees. They take knowledge, they create, and then file their own application. That is also valid.
Right, sir. One question is there. How inventor and applicant are different? Because in the form we require, we are required to mention who is the true and first inventor. So can there be two different people? Applicant is different and inventor is different.
Inventor has basic right over the invention, and he can file patent application as an applicant. In this case, the applicant and inventor are same. But inventor is not able or prohibited from filing his own application, and he has to assign the invention to his owner, employer, or university. Then he has to enter assignment deed or transfer of property. Then transferee or assignee becomes the owner of the patent. Inventor has no right on that. So applicant is different person. However, names of inventor is compulsory mentioned in the applications, and their signature are also required.
Yes. So I think this has been a very wonderful session today, a very in-depth one. So on behalf of all the participants, I thank you for such a nice talk. and such a knowledgeable talk on this very issue of patent filing and patent processing. I hope that all the participants have learned a lot. I personally learned a lot about the whole process. Definitely, we'll have more such sessions. So thank you, Dr. Dumane.
Thank you.
For
thank you
very spending much. Your valuable time today with us. And all the participants, you are requested to submit the feedback link. Once you submit the feedback link, then you'll be eligible for the e-certificate and it will be emailed to you. Please do not submit multiple feedbacks. Please only submit one feedback. So the session will still be live for next 1 minute. During this minute, you are requested to submit the feedback form. Once you have submitted, you are free to exit the platform. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Sajid. Thank you, everybody.